Raccoon, Senator Lee.
Mr. Olson, I'd like to clarify, has anyone been charged with the crime of insurrection following January 6th?
I am not aware that anyone has been charged with that particular offense, even if it is an offense. I just am not aware of that. And again, it would be inappropriate for me to speak about any particular investigation at this point, but I'm not aware of anyone being charged with that offense.
I'm not either. I've just heard that word used several times today, and to my knowledge, nobody's been charged with that. They've been charged with other things, not that one. On June 7th of 2021, I signed on to a letter with a bunch of my colleagues. The letter was led by Senator Johnson. And the purpose of the letter was to ask a number of questions regarding the prosecution of individuals alleged to have committed crimes in connection with the 2020 riots, and those alleged to have committed crimes on January 6th. Despite the best efforts of my staff to work with the Department of Justice to narrow the scope and prioritize certain questions, we didn't receive any answer until October 22nd, over 4.5 months after we sent the letter. Now, ordinarily, you'd think that when you've got more than 4.5 months to respond, that you'd submit a response that was at least good or thorough. But to my great astonishment and dismay, the letter failed to answer a single question that we asked, not one. I mean, it was a statement of platitudes and cited publicly available resources about general policies. There was not one answer to a single one of our questions. It's a little bit troubling when you've got members of the United States Senate charged with an oversight responsibility over the Department of Justice to have a 4.5 month delay followed by a complete refusal to engage. So I'd like to ask some questions based on that letter, and happy that I get the chance to do so here under oath, where I don't have to wait 4.5 months only to be given a non-responsive answer. So first, I'd like to know, did federal law enforcement utilize geolocation data from cell phones to track protesters associated with the unrest in the spring and summer of 2020?
Senator, if that question is directed to me, I don't have any information about that question that could be responsive.
I'd be happy to receive the answer from either one of you. Ma'am, do you have any?
Sir, without going into specifics on a specific case, I would just say that we do often use geolocation data in the course of our investigations as a result of legal process that we would serve.
I understand that you do. I'm asking whether you did so in connection with the riots that occurred in the spring and the summer of 2020. And if so, how many times and for which locations and riots? And what about January 6th? I'd like to know the number of times and locations.
Yes, sir. I don't have that in front of me, but happy to take that back. I wasn't aware of your questions until today, so I'm happy to take your question and try to see what we can do to be responsive.
Okay. Now, how many individuals who may have committed crimes associated with the riots in the spring and summer of 2020 were either arrested by law enforcement pre-dawn through pre-dawn raids and with SWAT teams, or had search warrants served on them through those means?
Sir, I don't have the particular numbers of arrests and or the specific nature of the op plan that might have been around that in front of me.
Okay. I'd also like to know how many were alleged to have committed crimes or alleged to have been witnesses to what happened on January 6th were people who had been arrested or had warrants served on them using pre-dawn raids and SWAT teams. Can you tell me at least an approximate number, or whether it's a comparable number to those who had those executed or arrested in connection with the spring and summer riots of 2020?
So I don't have either of those in front of me, and I would just, as a little preamble, would explain that the mechanics going behind time of day and when an arrest and how an arrest is done is very specific to each individual case and what potential threat they may or may not pose. But I don't have numbers or comparisons with me at this time.
Okay. You have any way of telling me how many of these individuals who were arrested in connection with the spring and summer riots of 2020 were placed in solitary confinement?
I don't have that, and I'm not exactly sure that the FBI would house that data, but I definitely don't have that, and I'm not sure we would have that. We could probably figure out how to direct you to the right organization for that.
Mr. Olson, do you have any idea how many of these individuals were offered deferred resolution agreements? That is, the individuals arrested in connection with offenses during the spring and summer of 2020?
I do not, Senator, have that specific information. Some of those cases, of course, are still ongoing out of that time period, as are the January 6th cases. I don't have any information about how many cases have been resolved via plea offers or plea agreements versus going to trial.
Okay, I see my time's expired. I'm gonna ask the two of you to answer these questions and others that I will submit as questions for the record. I understand that you've got big jobs to do, but I don't want 4.5 months to elapse again, and I certainly don't want a response that is non-responsive. Thank you.
Thank you, Senator Lee. Senator Blumenthal.